Thank you. Thank you. Afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm happy to welcome you here today on behalf of Rotary Club 99. I'd like to pay a special thanks to Mayor Frank Scott, City Board members Director Irma Hendricks, Director Ken Richardson, Director Kathy Webb, Director Cappy Peck, Director Lance Hines, who is with us here today in the auditorium, Director Doris Wright, Vice Mayor Brenda Wyrick, Dr. Dean Compuris, Gene Fortson, and Director Joan Adcock. Police officers, firefighters, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. As I said earlier, I'm Hank Kelly, president of Rotary Club of Little Rock, known worldwide as Club 99. On behalf of Fire Chief Delphon Hubbard and Police Chief Keith Humphrey, we invite you to celebrate with us the 28th annual Rotary Club of Little Rock Police and Fire Awards. We are excited and honored to be sharing this time with members of the Arkansas Symphony Brass Quintet that you just heard a beautiful 30 minutes worth of music specially prepared for each of you. On trumpet, Ross Allhorn and Carl Mason. On horn, Robin Dower. Trombone, Michael Underwood. And tuba, Ed Owen. Thank you to Rotarian member Christina Littlejohn for helping us arrange this beautiful musical ensemble. Thank you to Rotarian Gretchen Hall for helping us with Robinson Auditorium to set the stage for that production. Please accept our virtual and actual applause. Ladies and gentlemen, this event is historic. The pandemic has challenged us to gather the framework of this program within the internet. We've marshaled a small army of IT angels to guide us through all the technical connections. We're generating our ceremony today through StreamYard, live streaming platform, and delivering it to Facebook and YouTube for the convenience of the honorees' family, friends, and connections. So, please call, invite your friends, and tell them now they can click on this ceremony and join us live. That's www.facebook.com/RotaryClub99/, or in YouTube, www.youtube.com/watch?V. For those of you joining us for the first time, we want you to know the Rotary Club of Little Rock includes 360 members. We are people of action, and we are one of over 35,000 Rotary Clubs embracing over 1,200,000 members around the world. We have a motto, service above self. We are guided by what is known in Rotary, the Rotary world, as the four-way test. Here to guide us through the four-way test and to offer our invocation, pledge, star-spangled banner, and pledge of allegiance, we welcome Club 99 past president and Pastor Randy Hyde. Pastor Randy Hyde.
Thank you, President Hank. Would you please, Rotarians, join me in the four-way test of the things we think, say, or do? Is it the truth? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships? Will it be beneficial to all concerned? May we pray together. Almighty God, admittedly, we find ourselves living in turbulent times. Distrust and anger seem to be the name of the game, and much of that, due to recent and ongoing events, is aimed at the institutions we are focusing on today. Yet our purpose today is to honor those who have represented their professions and our community according to the highest standards of compassion and service above self. We ask for guidance, not to mention a healthy dose of courage and maybe even gumption, as to how we can be involved in healing that which divides us so we can be a part of the solution rather than the problem. Today, we will be hearing stories of uncommon valor, or perhaps simply the doing of one's job exceptionally well. Whatever it will be, may we be inspired by these stories to work together so that our community might be one in spirit, seeing no divisions between race or creed, but joining together in peace so that your will might be done here on earth as it is in heaven. Inspire us with your presence and encourage us by what we experience this day is our prayer in your name. Amen. May we stand for the national anthem. Standing and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
And to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Pastor Hyde. We appreciate that. At this time, I'd like to ask Mayor Frank Scott to join us. He's available via a link. I believe he wants to say a few words to us via a link. Mayor Scott, are you there?
Yes, I am. Good morning, fellow Rotarians. It is indeed a pleasure to be with you as you continue the historic legacy of recognizing and sharing appreciation and gratefulness to the men and women of the Little Rock Police Department and the Little Rock Fire Department. Now to those who guard, protect, and keep all of us safe, the men and women of the Little Rock Police Department and the Little Rock Fire Department exhibits the true definition of public safety, exhibits the true definition of securing our neighborhoods that we continue to enjoy the quality of life and place here in this great city of Little Rock. As we know, the year 2020 has been a year of expectation and uncertainty. However, even though we did not expect a global pandemic, a period of civil unrest, and now our generation's justice movement, one thing that we are certain of the men and women of these two great organizations that are waking up every day to protect, to serve, and to guard all of us as residents of Little Rock. And we want to share our gratefulness and appreciation to what you do for each one of us. As we know, it is our duty, it is our goal to protect and serve, but also to unite this city through community policing, through community servanthood, and through the fire department in securing all of our neighborhoods. And so each man, each woman is called, and we are grateful. We're grateful for your concern, your courage, and your commitment to this city. And on behalf of the city of Little Rock, I want you to know how much we appreciate you and pray for each one of you each day and night that you return home to your families. And we say thank you and God bless.
Thank you, Mayor Scott. I appreciate those words of encouragement, and thank you also for being part of our Rotary Club and your participation with our club. As we begin, let me share how grateful we are as Rotarians for the partnerships that we formed with the Little Rock Police Department, Little Rock Fire Department, but also our business community that helps sponsor this event today, providing some of the funds needed for the awards that are here. McDonald's, just look for those golden arches, is one of our sponsors. Arvest Bank, a community bank focused on your needs and a member of FDIC. We're here to pay tribute to firefighters, police officers who are at our call around the clock. To help us, we've recruited veteran Rotarians from across the city. Reporting here from the Little Rock Police Training Facility, I'm pleased to be joined by former Club 99 president and former vice chancellor at UA Little Rock, Mr. Bob Denman. Also on hand are Rotarians Elizabeth Solano and our Police and Fire Awards Committee Chair, Kathleen McDonald. Director Lance Hines, as I mentioned earlier, is present here and is pleased to be part of this program. Our reporting team at the Fire Department Training Facility on Murray Street and 69th is led by our president-elect of our club, Jeff Hildebrand. Jeff will be taking over the job of president in 2 weeks. And Jeff, I am thankful for that. I appreciate you. He is joined by another future club president and veteran Rotarian, Denver Peacock. Also on hand is Rotarian Rochelle Yance. Director Joan Adcock is attending at the fire department site to help honor our firefighters and their team. Ladies and gentlemen, to get things underway and share some special awards, here is President-elect Jeff Hildebrand. Jeff, would you please take it over?
Thank you, President Hank, and good afternoon to all. Hank, I see that smile on your face, and I know this is because you've got 2 weeks left as president of Rotary. You've done an outstanding job, and I can't begin to even think how I'm going to even step in your shoes, even though I'm 6'7", and you're like 5'9", but I'm certainly going to try. Before I get started, I'm going to deviate from script just a bit. Fellow Rotarian and Board of Directors member Cappy Peck is here with us as well, so I want to make sure recognize that she is in attendance with us, and we appreciate her and Director Adcock being here, as well as a few family and friends for this auspicious event. We're honoring firefighters and police officers. The firefighters are protecting our city as well as the police officers each and every day. I'm pleased to introduce the chief of the fire department, Delphon Hubbard, to share a few remarks. Chief.
Thank you, President Jeff. In 2 weeks, right?
2 weeks.
Right. Good afternoon to each of you. To the members of the Rotary Club of Little Rock, Mayor Frank Scott, members of the Board of Directors, and those in attendance, thank you. Thank you for your continued support of those of us individuals who have been selected to serve this community as public safety professionals. I would like to extend a special thank you to President-elect Jeff Hildebrand. Thanks so much, Club 99 President Bob Denham, and Awards Committee Chair Kathleen McDonald. Thank you guys so much for acknowledging the work of the members of the Little Rock Fire Department. Just to share a small overview of our activities we had as a department in 2019, we've continued to operate as a cohesive unit. We have responded to over 33,000 incidents. We conducted over 44,000 inspections of businesses, and we've identified over 5,250 code violations. We installed over 500 smoke detectors in residential properties throughout the community. All of these preventive measures were the resulted in zero fire fatalities for this community in 2019. As we proceed into the year 2020, we have been greeted, as the mayor stated, by various challenges as a nation, as a city, and as a department. Yet, as firefighters, we continue to adapt and overcome. Each time the call for assistance has been rendered, your Little Rock firefighters are responding in an efficient and effective manner. with a commitment to professional service. But this ceremony is not about anything other than the identified professionals and their heroic efforts that are being recognized today. The men and women you are honoring today are well deserving of the various awards. And if you asked them about it, they would say, "I was just doing my job." Yet, this isn't just a job, it's a profession filled with people that are committed and passionate about serving those members of this community and the visitors that come into this city. I would like to say congratulations from the Fire Chief's office to those members who are being acknowledged today. And thanks again to Club 99 and your membership for the support and acknowledgement of the work of the men and women they perform on a daily basis. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief. Due to our Rotary time constraints, we have asked both the fire department and the police department to share with us their top six award recipients for today's tribute. The fire department went in a big step further and gave us the names of no less than 24, each of whom is to receive the Little Rock Fire Department Life-Saving Award. The police department reported 19 incidents that will also warrant getting the Little Rock Police Department life-saving recognition. That's at least 43 separate lives saved by these firefighters and police officers. In moments of crisis, they called upon their training and personal instincts, and they saved the life of one of our friends or neighbors, on and off duty, firefighters and police officers. Answer the call. Bridge jumpers, fire victims, flood victims, even a fellow firefighter or police officer struggling in distress. Each receives a life-saving award. We will also extend our recognition of their efforts this Sunday in the Arkansas section of the Democrat Gazette. With our first award here is Denver Peacock.
Thank you, Jeff. At this time, we direct our attention to one of the special awards presented by the Little Rock Fire Department. The Meritorious Service Award is reserved for those firefighters who have a long term of exemplary service, 15 years or more. The recipient must become involved with a charity or support program. This year's Meritorious Service Medal winner has actually been with the department more than 20 years. He has seen it all and has hit every fire hydrant in the city, probably more than once. We are proud to pass along this plaque and this award this year to Captain Roger Poole. Captain Poole. Thank you for your service.
A few years ago, we lost firefighter Gavin Wright to a battle with cancer. And in his honor, the department created the Gavin Wright Resilience Award. It is reserved for a member of the department who embodies the "I can, I will" spirit reflected in Gavin Wright's determination to overcome challenges, no matter how great the obstacle. Let's flash forward to the spring of 2018. Firefighter Stanley Scott's awesome wife, Janet, talked him into asking his doctor about Stanley's repeated fatigues and discomfort. A series of tests revealed a large cancerous tumor in the colon. Surgery and a scary 6 days in the hospitals were followed by 6 months of chemo. Finally, after a year of toughing through it, he was declared cancer-free. Stanley Scott, your colleagues awarded you the Gavin Wright Resilience Award in a department ceremony held earlier today. We want to make it public. Congratulations.
Thank you, Jeff. It's not very often a 33-year-old guy is considered a rookie, but that's what we have today. The Little Rock Fire Department usually taps somebody young to be Recruit of the Year, but today our recipient is a product of Whitehall High and UCA. He's got a BA in English and creative writing. He spent the first 6 months on duty with Engine 8 at Central Station. He has moved on now to Engine 3. But let the record show, this 33-year-old racked up an outstanding performance through training and the early moments on duty. Mr. Conley Boyd has earned him the honor of Recruit of the Year. We'd like to insert a special note that this year's Recruit of the Year award is underwritten by BXS Insurance for your home, your business, your employees, your car, your boat. BXS has you covered. Congratulations to the Little Rock Fire Department firefighter Conley Boyd, and go Bears.
The Little Rock Fire Department Person of the Year is someone who provides major contributions that positively impact the department. This person presents a superior work ethic, and their contributions far exceed the duty requirements of their position. In other words, they go above and beyond what's expected of them. This person exhibits boundless professionalism and dedication to the Little Rock Fire Department. The Little Rock Fire Department Person of the Year is firefighter Matthew Stallings. Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have one more marquee award. Thanks to the generous support of the Hatcher Agency and Kelly Commercial Partners, we share with you the LRFD Firefighter of the Year. He is a former Razorback baseball player. He and wife, Maggie, are the proud parents of three children. He has been with the LRFD for 11 years, and he's running for the ledge in District 38. Now, here's the backstory. Many of us sadly recall firefighter Nathaniel Crum, who lost a lengthy battle with cancer. Firefighter Crum exhausted all his sick leave while undergoing treatment. As a tribute to him, our Firefighter of the Year spearheaded the drive to pass Arkansas House Bill 1773, what we now know as Crum's Law. It ensures firefighters receive up to 6 months leave of sick leave when faced with fighting job-related cancer issues. We are honored to ask firefighter Matthew Stallings from Engine 3 to return to the front to not only accept Person of the Year Award, but also the LRFD Firefighter of the Year Award. Again, we want to thank an old friend with a new name in the commercial real estate business, Kelly Commercial Partners, and a pillar in the insurance industry, the Hatcher Agency, for their continued support recognizing the Firefighter of the Year. Sissy's Log Cabin also has something for Matthew Stallings to wear on his wrist, so he is sure to make, is sure to make it to the firehouse on time. Thank you, David and Sissy, for your support. Did we mention a check for $1,000? All right. Well, you get that too. All right, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, Firefighter of the Year, Matthew Stallings. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Congratulations to all the LRFD leaders. These firefighters are part of a much larger family of men and women who have been recognized by their peers and leadership for their outstanding service to the city of Little Rock. We hope you'll pick up a copy of the Sunday Democrat Gazette to learn more. And permit me to insert a brief plug and thank you to the people who made this all possible, namely, Arvest Bank, a leader in community banking throughout Arkansas, member FDIC, and ABPG, the Arkansas Business Publishing Group, which brings you Arkansas business and soiree and specialty publications statewide. And of course, thank you to the Little Rock Fraternal Order of Police. Jeff?
Thank you, Denver. I'm sorry I put you in a tough spot there with the Sissy's gift, but we certainly appreciate Sissy's and what they do for this award and for our Rotary Club. We'd like to thank Fire Department Division Chief Brad Jones and Captain Brent Buford for hosting our awards presentation here at the Little Rock Fire Department Training Facilities. Now, Hank, as much as I know you'd like for me to keep the mic, I've got to turn it over to you for at least a couple more times. Please take it away, Hank Kelly and Bob Denvin.
With the Little Rock Police Department. To help us get this underway, it's my pleasure to introduce the Chief of the Little Rock Police Fire Department, Chief Keith Humphrey. Chief, would you please come forward and share some thoughts with us? Thank you.
Thank you. With recognition and introduction protocol already been established, I want to say thank everybody for being here. To our recipients, congratulations. I'll tell you, one day you'll really realize what this means. It may not be today, it may not be tomorrow, but at some point in your career, you're going to realize that the respect and the recognition that you're receiving today. You know, we talk about resilience and we talk about passion. We talk about selflessness. That's the Little Rock Police Department. It is full of officers, although we're recognizing our employees today, several of our employees, but we have a department full of men and women, whether commissioned or whether civilian, that go out every day and to ensure that we provide an amazing customer service to our citizens. I continue to say that we only exist because our citizens allow us to exist. And so we have to provide the top quality service. These men and women that are here today are only part of the family that helped us last year have a 7% decrease in overall crime. Those are things that you don't hear about. You hear about sometimes all the negative things, but I wanted to share that with our citizens, a 7% decrease in overall crime. That's based on the hard work of these men and women. That's based on the fact that these men and women on a daily basis, they go out. Even during our COVID pandemic, we had to change the way we were doing things with the Little Rock Police Department. Not one time did these men and women think about going to have second thought about going to work, have second thought about the changes that had to be made. And so I'm proud and honored to be the police chief for this city and to serve men and women of this magnitude. So without further ado, I guess we'll get started.
Thank you, Chief. A few minutes ago, fellow Rotarian Jeff Hildebrand mentioned the firefighters and police officers who received life-saving awards. It's important to note 19 of those awards are for Little Rock police officers whose actions were triggered by drug overdoses, knife wounds, gunshot wounds, suicide attempts, quick work with bandages, tourniquets, Narcan, you name it. These men and women epitomize the term law enforcement professionals. I'd like now to introduce Bob Denman to you to start our awards process. Bob, would you please come forward?
Employee, Captain Ken Temple, commander of the Special Investigations Division, summed up his nominating memorandum in writing, and I quote, "To put it the best way I can, Debbie Smith is the perfect employee. Debbie has been with the LRPD 27 years. She is a virtual encyclopedia and the go-to person whenever difficult questions come up. Background checks, freedom of information requests, criminal histories, file after file, policy after policy, all of it with a smile and all of it with a great attitude. She is responsible for a huge amount of sensitive information and produces volumes of work each and every day. She is a great Little Rock Police Department asset. Congratulations to Kimberly Finkelstein, Memorial Civilian Employee of the Year winner, Debbie Smith. Congratulations, Debbie. Time for a brief commercial. And our Club 99 treasurer-elect, Dennis Hunt, for their generosity as well. When you see some of these familiar folks, please say thank you for all their good work in supporting this event.
Thank you.
apologize for, we've had a little bit of technical difficulties at the police department, and Chief Hubbard's over here smiling from ear to ear. I don't know what that's about, but I'm sure him and Chief Humphreys will have a conversation later. But I'm going to take over for Bob. I won't do near as good a job, but I'll try. We want to mention some of our sponsors, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Arkansas Blue Cross Blue Shield through BAT, and his colleagues at Baptist, Rotarian Troy Wells, Rotarian Jay Chesser, and the Little Rock Chamber Regional Chamber of Commerce. Also, a special thanks to Rotarian Gene Pfeiffer and the folks at North Shore Business Park. We need to thank Sam Alley, fellow Rotarian with VCC, and our Club 99 treasurer-elect Dennis Hunt for their generosity. When you see these familiar folks affiliated with these supporters, we hope you'll say thanks. Denver?
Thank you, Jeff. It was over a year ago, March 2019, when officers were dispatched to a disturbance at the Kroger grocery store on Colonel Glenn Road. They were met by a woman who complained her boyfriend had taken several items from her car. Officers contacted the driver and began to pat him down for their own safety. The suspect pulled away and failed to cooperate with verbal instructions and attempted to flee. One of those responding was police officer Lisa Nava. In the altercation that followed, Officer Nava was struck in the face by a suspect's knee. She proceeded to pursue the suspect and assisted in placing him under arrest. They also found a handgun and illegal drugs. Officer Nava was injured and hospitalized. She suffered a stroke. Sergeant Wes Butler nominated her for the LRPD Police Shield Award, and the review committee obviously agreed. I know she's not here with me, but we'd like to say thank you, Officer Lisa Nava, for your dedication to duty and exceptional work. Jeff?
The Little Rock Police Department honors the Recruit of the Year with the annual Noel Don McGuire Memorial Award. It is named after a Little Rock police officer who was killed in the line of duty over 40 years ago. This year's outstanding recruit put together an impressive report card. Academic average, 92.2%. Physical fitness, 89.6%. Firearms, 94%. Overall score was 91.9%. Ladies and gentlemen, this award is also underwritten by BXS Insurance. You're covered at home, at the office, on the road, or on the water. It's BXS. The Little Rock Police Department Recruit of the Year is Officer Christopher Flowers. Congratulations. Wish we were there with you, but congratulations.
Thank you, Jeff. A few years ago, the chief of the department was Lawrence Johnson. He took the unusual step of adding an award category to recognize officers who exhibited outstanding leadership in the course of their duties. It's now known as the Lawrence Johnson Leadership Award. The winner is a veteran officer with a resume that reads like a leadership roadmap. While serving with the homicide unit, he was a big contributor to a clearance rate of over 80% of cases. That is much higher than the national average. And he stepped in to fill homicide sergeant's role when one of his colleagues became ill. And there was a vacancy in the crime scene search unit with its 11 employees. Bottom line, 8 detectives and 11 CSSU civilians meant taking on supervisory responsibility for some 19 personnel. Lieutenant Zebby Burnett wrote in her nominating memorandum, "Sergeant Jared McCauley is the epitome of a leader, consistently demonstrating a myriad of leadership qualities." The review committee agrees. The Lawrence Johnson Leadership Award is presented this year to Sergeant Jared McCauley. Congratulations. We need to recognize a few more financial angels who helped make this all possible. So please bear with me. Our beloved Rotarian Rick Fleetwood and the staff at Snell Prosthetics have been a huge help. Courtney Little at Ace Glass is another big contributor. And we better not forget First Community Bank and Miguel Lopez. Jeff?
The annual Marquee Award for the Little Rock Police Department is the Chief Stuart Thomas Officer of the Year, underwritten by Delta Dental with individual and family dental plans. To get the inside scoop, we turned to notes from Administrative Assistant Sandra Scott, who prepared the nomination. When the public affairs officers went to train with the FBI at Quantico, our Officer of the Year stepped in and filled the role without skipping a beat. He did it in addition to his role as the Crime Stoppers Coordinator. You've seen him on your TV screen fielding questions from probing reporters and TV cameras. He has been the right officer in the right place at the right time. He has served as a detective in the Southwest Division and as a juvenile detective with the Major Crimes Division. Ms. Scott goes on to write, "This officer is one of those employees you wish you could clone." Ladies and gentlemen in Rotarian, the Little Rock Police Department Delta Dental Chief Stuart Thomas, Officer of the Year is Eric Barnes. Eric, congratulations. Sissy's Log Cabin will keep Officer Barnes on time in the future with a brand new watch and a nice $1,000 check to help keep you on spoiling those two beautiful kids in your life. Congratulations, Officer Barnes. I believe we're ready to turn it back over to the police department. With that, Hank, take it away.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're back from our commercial break. Before we go any further this afternoon, we'd like to introduce a very special Rotarian, a very special friend to police and firefighters throughout the 2nd Congressional District. Ladies and gentlemen, our Congressman, the Honorable French Hill. French, please.
It's my privilege to join my fellow Rotarians in Club 99 and acknowledge the dedication of our Little Rock police and firefighters. The challenge of the last few months have renewed our admiration for our police and fire leadership and their service and sacrifice throughout Arkansas's 2nd Congressional District. We'd be remiss in our celebration today if we did not also acknowledge your families, their service, their sacrifice. And I know you'll join me in recognizing their love and support across this community. Likewise, I'm grateful that our community comes together and collaborates to have a better environment to support our police and fire. And that sense of service above self is truly what Little Rock's all about, and you'll find Club 99 members at the heart of it every time something good happens. Please know that while the pandemic has prevented us from physically being together for this year's tribute and expression of gratitude, know that that doesn't stop us from our affection and saying thanks for all your service and sacrifice to keep Little Rock safe and sound.
Thank you, Congressman Hill. That was a nice musical exit that you just created for us. Our sincere thanks to you, Congressman Hill, for saying those words and being with us. We've got one more surprise for you. For the past 28 years, as you all know, we've staged our Police and Fire Awards a little earlier in the year, and we make it a tribute luncheon. Hundreds of us get together and share a huge buffet. As you know, we can't do that during the pandemic. So we're delighted to announce that the Rotary Club of Little Rock, in partnership with your neighborhood McDonald's, is presenting a $10 gift certificate to every Little Rock police officer and every Little Rock firefighter and every member of the police and fire department's civilian support staff. Yes, those famous fries come with that. We can't wait to see you all at the Golden Arches. And to each of the officers and firefighters we recognize today, our sincere congratulations. Due to the pandemic and associated technical constraints, which you've witnessed some of those today, we want everyone to know these award acknowledgments will continue in the next few days on other media platforms, including the Arkansas Democrat Gazette this Sunday. The spirited leaders and chair of this event which it would not happen without, is Chair Kathleen McDonald. Kathleen is here. And our Vice Chair, Rotarian Ted Jones. The two of them work each and every year to script this ceremony, to work with the police and fire departments, to give them time to make the recognition and awards. And this year, of course, we had special challenges related to trying to create a virtual format that could be available to as many families as possible. So Kathleen and Ted, on behalf of our Rotary Club, and I think I can say on behalf of the men and women of the Little Rock Police Department and Little Rock Fire Department, we say thank you for your service to this community. We'd also like to take another minute to say thanks to the Arkansas Symphony Brass Quintet for setting the stage for us prior to the meeting starting and playing the national anthem for us. That was pre-recorded in Robinson Auditorium, thanks to the work of our own Rotarian Gretchen Hall and Christina Littlejohn, who is the director of, or the manager of the Arkansas Symphony. Again this year, the public affairs police officers were a huge help. Lieutenant Michael Ford, Officer Eric Barnes, our Officer of the Year, and Officer Tracy Brandon. Fire department support was crafted by our friend firefighter, Bo Hager, and in the administrative office, Octiva Ashford. We want to pay special attention and thanks to Rotarian Natalie Gadotti and her Tiger team at Gadotti Communications for guiding us through this technical experiment that we've had today. And big thanks to Content Titan leader Nate DeSaro. Nate is here on the phone still working and his video crews. Rotarian Jay Cranford with his staff at Cranford Co. completed our list of special helpers. And as always, our virtual parachute at all of these events is our own director, Karen Fetzer, and her able-bodied assistant, Lael Foster. To all of our sponsors and benefactors, I'd like to say a huge thank you. We can't do this program and present these awards without corporate support. Now, may I offer one closing thought to all the police, firefighters here and online. We want you to know we are forever grateful for your service and the service of your colleagues who are on duty out there as we meet. We understand there's a special thread that binds all dedicated first responders. It is in the heart and soul and character you bring to each call. It is what drives you to do the right thing. Please know, the leaders of this community and the members of our Rotary Club share a special privilege to be with you today to honor you. And we know your job is necessary, and without you working in the field doing what you do, our community cannot thrive. Ladies and gentlemen, our theme at Rotary this year is Together We Make Little Rock Thrive. You all are a huge part of that together definition. So together we make Little Rock thrive. Congratulations to all. Godspeed. Be safe. We are adjourned.